So starting from Team Com, this is pretty interesting. So they've got Nasus as their tank. Right. Morgana support. Lee Sin top. Lux mid. Misfortune. AD carry. Whatever. So yeah, I would definitely start 5 against Lee Sin top. And the only reason is because in our team, you're the only tanky person. Shyvana. The rest of us are squishy. This kind of team annoys me because we should have really had a tank jungle, or at least somebody tankier than a straight carry. But, you know, whatever. So, because you're going to be a tank, Cloth 5 is a pretty good start because it's built into Warden's Mail, Miranda Woodens, which is pretty important. And so,
a summoner has reconnected.
Heim here sees Morgana go into the bush, right? He sees Morgana go in there, pings danger, and then just walks about when he knows that they're invading. This was such a bad play by Heimer. He's just like sitting here. You're lucky you didn't follow him. And then, he might have even been able to get out if he barriered, walked a little bit more, and flashed over the wall, but he deserved that so much, and this was good of you to leave. Although, I told Yi in chat, go do your own blue, because usually when teams get first blood on invading, they don't actually care about taking the buff, they just want the first blood. And then he's like, no, I'll go take it and look at all of them coming over here. And so they have vision of Yi and there, and then he's like, oh shit, he doesn't need to flash there because they don't have the CC to hold him there. But and then, oh, you should have seen that. That was actually pretty cool. Jump back. So Yi gets caught or whatever, and he flashes immediately when I didn't really need to, but you know. Morgana comes to snare him, and he Qs through the snare and does a lot of damage. And so we're just kind of sitting over here bot lane, and then Miss Fortune tries running at us. And then, so we start off bot lane pretty easy since the support and the AD carry are low. Let's look at you top lane. So I watched this a little bit earlier, but this was a really good trade on your part. You did a really good job there. Stop. He shouldn't have fought you there. Now, what he was going for there is the fact that his second Q. You shouldn't have flashed there to try and pick up the kill. And then you should have also died from him hitting that skill shot, but luckily he's bad. And right now, since you started Claw 5, he started Longsword 2. So you've got more sustain than him. You should just, drink your bots and go back to lane. You should have to be careful now, because look, before when you were trading with him, stop, camera. Before when you were trading with him, he only had 2 minions there. Now he's got this giant wave. And see, the thing is that every time you use this burnout, you see you're pushing the wave. You're not last hitting. You're just, stop. What the fuck? God damn it. You're sitting here constantly pushing the wave, constantly pushing the wave. Anasis obviously started at blue. We already knew that. Of course, he's gonna go up through his jungle. Stop! Fucking directed camera. So obviously, he's gonna come up through his jungle to come and gank you. And you saw Lee Sin was pinging for assistance. Well, of course he was. He was getting outplayed. So, you were shoving the lane, you were making it really, really easy for him to come and gank. And luckily for you, he's not actually going tank. And right now, I'm looking at his skill points. He didn't put a point in Wither yet. They probably could have killed you if he put a point in Wither, but, you know, whatever. It was a bad play. They could have played that better, and you're lucky that they didn't play it as well, that they played it as badly as they did. So, you're still up here, you've got no pots left, and your top laner has gone back. So you're going to be facing a Lee with full HP, and let's see what he got. You got another long sword, a ward, and one pod. There he withered you. So let's see. See what happens. So you're low. You're getting low. Now you've got vision of Lee. Yeah, that's a good time to back off. See, Nass is just leaving. Let's take a look at what's happening bot lane. I don't think I've killed them yet. Oh, look how far Nasus is. He gets snared under turret, and he auto-attacks her to draw aggro. And then Nasus comes, and they're fighting under his turret. So let's see what happens. The Ignite's gonna get him. Oh my god, that was hilarious. He just sat there under the towers. Yeah, his flash was back up, though. So Lee Sin just shoved all the way. And doesn't know how to farm under tower. But... just buzzing. What's his farm at? He's at 22 farm. He keeps missing his skill shots. That's actually really lucky for you that he keeps missing his skill shots. So you hit his skill shot, but let's see if you follow up on it. You didn't even auto attack him. You probably weren't expecting that. But better dodge this. Dodge the Q. I can't. You kind of juked him. You switched directions. Good job. So he went back and got another long sword. He's got 113 AD, 113, and you've got 94, and you've got some armor. But he's got abilities that cause him to do more damage. Because you know his passive is that he gets increased attack speed after using an ability. So you guys, you can sit there and try and auto attack trade with him, but he's gonna get in more auto attacks than you. Always. If you wanna trade with him, you gotta do it in like short bursts. Like put in your W, EM run up. Auto attack and then Q right afterwards to reset your auto attack timer, and then you can back off. Cause that'll do a lot of damage. And so Nasus comes, let's look at what's happening. Bot. Nasus comes bot. I'm out of mana. Lulu saves my life by speeding me up. I sit there spamming laugh. I'm lol. We can see him here. Because somebody auto attacked from Brush. Dude, I'm waiting for her to snare me. I'm trying to bait it out. And she won't do it. And then she finally does do it, I believe. And she just misses. Ah, stop. Oh, I dashed it. Alright, so let's see what's going on top. You both got your ulties. He's got a brutalized mess. He's gonna deal a lot of damage. And you're still trying to trade with him. Which is fine up until the point where he tries to trade with you. And you see, he uses his abilities defensively instead. You should probably, honestly, what I would have done there is if you were so determined to fight him, get behind him right there, that exact point where he W'd back to the creep, is when I would go around back here. Stop showing me drag. Gone around behind him and then ulted him this way. Because your ult does a large amount of damage. Yeah, 200 magic damage. And he didn't have much HP. Yeah, he only had about 300 HP. Speed of thought. So yeah, you basically, you died because he ulted and you didn't. If you would have... As Shivani, you're supposed to initiate fights with your ult. You're not supposed to use your ult to get the finishing blow, like Lee's kind of is. You kind of use at least AD Lee. I got here. You know, Lee's combo is Q, ult, and then Q again for the execution. You're supposed to initiate with your ult, because then all your abilities get better, but, you know. That would have been the better thing to do, but then again, he does have more damage, and you have to watch out for that. So, you're coming back to lane with just HP. And he's just AFKing. So you're missing a ton of creeps. You just missed so many creeps because you had your burnout on. Because you had your burnout on instead of last hitting. And again, you're shoving, which is fine because he's gone, but you're missing a lot of the creeps. Like, he's got 45 creeps and you've got 36, and there's no one there to contest you. And you're missing creeps. You know, this wasn't worth it. You should ult away. Okay, you can flash. He missed his Q. Don't be afraid to ult away from him. Like, your ult's not on a long cooldown. I mean, I know it doesn't really work with cooldowns, but Fury per second. I mean, you get 5 Fury per second, it's got a max cooldown of 100 seconds, and then if you're auto-attacking, it gets lower. Rampage. So, you really shouldn't have just let him do all that attacking for you on you while you were attacking the tower. Like, you'll get the tower eventually. I mean, it had a lot less health than your tower. You might have needed one more wave, but you forced yourself out of lane, and you really should have died. He should have been able to kill you, and he didn't. But you forced yourself out of lane just because you wanted that tower so badly, where if you would have waited one lane, you would have gotten it, and you wouldn't have had to almost die and leave lane for it. I don't know how to turn off directed camera. It's really getting on my nerves, and honestly, I'm doing that automatically. Oh, so you guys are fighting again. Oh, there you find. Oh! Honestly. Here, I wanna look at that again. So you get back in the lane. You see, Nasus is over there and he wasn't even planning to come up. But you're chasing them onto their side of the map. Chasing, and then Lee Sin starts pinging Nasus and asking for help. And so, you didn't go in the bush, you didn't see him. And then Lux was even coming too. Like, you're all the way on their side of the map. That was... I know you couldn't see him. You couldn't see Nasus, and you didn't know if he was coming or not. You could have probably looked at the timers and been like, oh, his red buff's probably up soon, he might be there. But, you shouldn't have chased him all the way to his side of the map without knowing where the jungler was. You should have just let him go. Let him back. Oh, I just got another kill. Easiest game of my life. I think Lulu's gonna get this. Oh, she didn't auto-attack. Close, though. Oh, see, look. Oh, let's just watch this bot real quick because everybody's coming. So Nasus and Lux are coming. Let's see how we handle this. So there, the Wither comes out. Lux is just chilling over there. I didn't know she was over there. That's funny. Oh, so she finally walks all the way around. Oh, and look, she uses her abilities on creeps. See what you're doing. Pushing the lane and missing CS. So I guess we already know that's one thing you should do is, even if you're pushing a lane, make sure you Oh, rip. Make sure that you're still getting the CS for it. So let's see, this creep, if you get it, you don't, you do get it, okay. And you missed the big creep, and that's the most important creep. So, yeah, I'm not even gonna mention stop missing creeps anymore, because you know that's awful, but. Let's see what's going on. You're still pushing without vision. You don't know where their jungler is. Actually, you know that the people just died in Lee's mid, so that's probably why you're pushing. So now, yeah, Lee was Mia. I don't know what caused you to run away, but that was a good idea, because they're all coming to kill you. So there's a lot of... Here, you could probably just go mid and shove. You can now you can see Lux in your wards. She really, really wants to kill you, and you're not even there. And then she finally sees you mid, and she's like, wow, I'm stupid. Oh, they're pinging you. They really want to kill you.
Has been destroyed.
Oh, we got the turret bot. Nasus is pushing up to your tower. Nasus can push towers pretty quickly because his Q procs on towers, the bonus damage. I really think a lot of the reason we won this game is that, you see, they don't have any wards on the map. I don't know why you went, there was no reason for you to go behind him, because you don't really have kill potential against that Nasus. Look at all those creeps you're missing just because you're chasing after a kill. And I know, at least, I mean, he's there, but you should have just let him go. I mean, I don't know if you end up killing him, but it doesn't look like you do. He's just too tanky. And now you guys are doing golems together. And you missed two waves top that you could have had. You know, and look how much tower damage you have. And a lot of that was just because of that creep wave with the siege minion sitting there. And so now you're overextended again. You're all the way over here. And the entire team has come for you because they know... They know that you left. I mean, yeah, warding this is good, but if you're gonna be over here, then you need to ward this, you need to ward this, maybe even this. So, you're just getting overextended. If shove the lane up to like the turn or something, somewhere where you feel like you don't ever want to go ahead of your ward. So you had a ward here at Tribush, you don't want to go past Tribush. You don't want them to be able to come up behind you without you knowing. So probably would have been best to go mid and shove this, or you could even jungle like the wolves and the wraiths.
That's out.
Dude, watch me come up behind this Misfortune. So Misfortune was doing the same thing. She was past her Tribush and she had no wards, and we just came up behind her. She flashed for no reason. And just absolutely destroyed her. I don't remember if we ended up getting Morgana too. Morgana came to save her, so she runs into a 1v3. I think she just gets away, actually. Because we know that there are people coming from mid, and they ping me to fall back. Let's see, I don't think I end up dying. Yeah, Heimerdinger flashes for the sick. Turret ult. Lux misses her ult. You're taking... Why are you taking red? That's not your red. That's my red. Yeah, you do take red. So... You take red. You didn't need red. It's really not... I probably could have used it better than you, but it's not like you're not going to be using it. And so... Oh, we know they're here. Let's see what you do. You clear bot. Okay. At least you got the big green. So they're doing that, and yeah, we don't have vision of it.
Purple team has slain the dragon.
So, oh, so they all just did drag, and we saw them doing drag, and then they're coming bot for you. Oh, you didn't dodge that. That would have been really easy to dodge if you had just walked backwards and then come back in. Luckily, Lux has like no damage because she rushed a thing into the Holy Grail, so she doesn't have much AP. And you got out of that. If you would have dodged the Morgana snare, you would have been a lot better off, but they came up behind you through your own try because you didn't have wards. And they just all happened to be there because they were doing drag. Which I think we knew. I believe we knew about. I think Lulu throws a ward over. If I remember correctly. I believe Lulu throws a ward over right here. Because we had this ward here and we just saw all three of them going here. Lulu puts a ward over the wall. Yeah. So we knew they were doing drag. I mean, you knew three of them were here. Misfortune, you didn't see, but you knew three of them were here. You might not have been watching, but there were three of them there and you had vision. And you're pushing up bot lane. So you gotta be wary of that because they're all like, oh, let's go kill her. It's 3v1. And you're just pushing farther and farther and farther. And luckily they don't do enough damage or you're tanking enough that you got out. And they... Lux snared you while you're still snared by Morgana. If she would have waited another second to snare you longer, I don't know. There's a lot of things that could have happened. But you get out and now there's three bot and so we're shoving mid. We're shoving mid because we know they can't defend this. Because three are bot. Nasus is here. Gonna come defend it while Lee Sin is just dicking around top lane. Lane's shoved and he's not doing anything about it. So he's finally doing something about it. You've got two towers in your lane. I think the second one was useful and you haven't lost your tower. And Lee Sin keeps missing his Qs. So look, he's coming all the way up from behind. He's going in. And he's gonna Q once he gets out of that. Come on. Come on, Yi. I killed both of them. Kill stole them. See what you're doing. I don't know. We're trying to push, so you're pushing mid. So you've not been here for a lot of our fights, to be honest. Most of the fights that you've been participating in have just been you getting caught. Or you trying to trade with Lee Sin in lane. It's not finally after all this time you're gonna go back top. Because he's shoving your lane. By the looks of it, you're gonna go through river when you should probably just go through tri-bush. Because you're gonna miss all of those creeps by going around. But yeah, you call me. Lost your turret. You wouldn't have been able to save it, but. So yeah, I'm missing creeps. But so, ooh, we're sitting here in the ward. I must not have been paying attention to my minimap, because I remember going there and thinking, oh, they must have done it. I wonder when they did that, even though we obviously had vision of them doing that a few minutes ago, and I didn't even pay attention. So there, I was just writing on you for not paying attention, and I hadn't paid attention either. And, oh, I don't know if this is a glitch or if we really double warded this, both of us. Maybe that's a glitch with replay, I don't know. Where am I? Did I recall? Yeah, I recall. Okay. So you're finally here. This is the first time, you know, at 21 minutes, this is the very first time you've actually been with the team. And, which is can be okay. I mean, we were winning. So, your job as the tank, you're also the only person with initiate on our team. You should have just auto-attacked Lee. This honestly made me so mad when you guys did this. Because I know I typed in chat, wait for me. And then Lee... Yi gets in position where Lee Sin can use the Q flash thing. God, that made me so mad because they're so low. I just needed somebody to tank. Oh, I knew she was gonna be. Oh, I wish I didn't have flash up. Oh, I do have flash up, but I don't want to flash into a snare because I've got so much CC. And then, oh, watch this. This is when I was just like, what the fuck, Lee? Alright, so. Oh, that missed. So I'm taking a lot of damage. Lee Sin comes up with like no HP. I crit him and Q him, and I'm just like, what the fuck, Lee? That was hilarious.
Blue team's turret has been destroyed.
Alright, so there's not much going on right now. They've actually got a lot of wards now. But your lane's not doing anything right now. It's gonna end up pushing because they've got more minions than you. Oh, you wanna see me fail here? You see me fail? So Lux is here and I'm like, oh, I can kill her. I can kill her. Oh, look at that drag timer. And for whatever reason, she's at 375 moon speed. I actually am faster than her. I don't know. It seemed like she was faster than me and I couldn't catch up to her. Ooh, that ult, that glitched. But, you know, whatever. I flashed when I really shouldn't have flashed. Shielded when she really shouldn't have ulted. It wasn't worth for me, but you know, I'll take it. What are you doing? You're jungling! Really? Well, I guess it's not that bad, but lane creeps will always give you more gold and XP than jungle creeps. If you can get lane creeps, get lane creeps. Okay. So you can see that we're all mid, and they're trying to push our tower, and you're not there. So here you come. Here you come.
Did you miss it?
What does he have? He's probably going to do something stupid again. Like a cued by Lee. Misfortune's doing stupid stuff. I'm doing stupid stuff. Look at me. I'm just pushing top, and I'm like, don't fight. There, you finally ult, but it's way, way too late, and I'm not there, which is my fault that I'm not there, but you should have just left. I should have been there, I shouldn't have been top, I should have been mid defending, because we could have probably killed them all, because I was so fed. I had a lot of AD with Bloodthirster and VF, and they pushed two towers out of that, and now, finally, I'm just like, oh, I'm here. And I dodged both snares, easiest game of my life. And then Morgana's just gonna go through the wall. Okay. Thanks. We'll replay. See, you're in base for a long time. Nasus Soul is the dragon. And so you were in base for a long time. I don't know if you were buying stuff or waiting on gold, but you were in base a lot longer than you were. Misfortune ultimate, so much damage. I managed to pick off Lee though. So you've got your ult this whole time. Which is good that you're not using it while they're under their tower. But let's see, let's see. I don't know why he put his... why Heim put his turret under their tower. I didn't know they had this warded. But so they had vision of us the whole time. Yeah, it was no secret. She keeps shooting all of her skill shots at him. So she's... yeah, and then I just burst Morgana. She thinks she's cool for snaring me, and I burst her. But yeah, Lux is using all of her long-range abilities and all her AoE abilities to try and poke at E in the bush, instead of trying to use it to poke on the four of us here. So here, there's five of us, and he initiates. You should have ulted right there, ulted right under Lee's head. And you're here, and you're still not ulting. Like, you're our initiation. Just ult, or get behind them and ult them back towards us. This whole time you held on to your ult for no good reason, because Lulu also has her ult. So if you go in, if you jump on them, Lulu can ult you and pop them all up. So don't be afraid about that. And you know, you're the tank. If anybody's gonna die, it's better you than me. Better you than me or Yi, really. Ult!
That's out.
Nah, don't ult, they're too far away. But if you ulted them and then had Lulu pop them up, like had Lulu ult you, ult! Actually, we're all getting kinda low. Oh, and he finally ult to get away. I don't think they're gonna be able to kill us. Oh, she hit me with- oh, that makes me so upset. Let me look at that again. She hit me with a skill shot that I could have dodged and I didn't. Yeah, because I had flash. I didn't see it until I had my camera in a weird spot and I didn't see it. So we kind of overstay our welcome. And we all die for that inhibitor. We could have probably gotten it and left earlier, or just not gotten it and gotten it later without dying, but luckily for us, they're really stubborn, and they're like, no, I believe this is the first time they Baron. Yeah, they're pinging it. They decided to Baron instead of pushing down our inhibitor right here. This is a really, really bad play for them. Especially because Nass is old. He's not gonna ult it, but... There he ults. So we know they're doing it, but we don't have any pink wards or anything, so let's see Heimer here. Once again, Heimer thinks he can 1v11 the team. Luckily, he hits a double stun there, which was amazing. Eddie, we just blows his ult. Lux is just AFK. Yeah, she really was just AFK. Alright, so let's see, your ult's back up. Yeah, there it goes. Back up. You still have that ward in that bush. They just rewarded it. And I'm like, hold on, let me get red buff. I really needed the red buff in this game so I could kite Nasus. I needed the slow really badly. And I know you came over here because I told you to do drag, but I wanted to do it with the team, and the team was in there fighting them, and they actually managed to kill one of them, and so that's when I was like, wait, no, let's just get their base. If we already killed Lee Sin, we can probably kill more and just win right here. If we can kill Misfortune and Lux, we'll be good. And so that's why I was just like, no. I guess here we could have just gone around here and started like attacking these minions to draw them away from this turret, because we couldn't fight them while they are over here bot. We had needed them to come over here. So we're kind of not really doing anything. Spamming laugh again. Because the only person who can really do anything on our team is you, unfortunately. Just ult. You should just ult. Just ult, and Lulu will ult you. That probably would have come out better if you ulted, but I don't know, our Heim was pretty useless. Lulu died pretty quickly, but and they had Baron buff, so... But she seemed to hold onto your ult a lot. For no particular reason. Oh my god, this is so bad. They don't even know. Alright, so they're just jump. Alright. Here you come.
Up we go!
So you fight without, well, not you. They fight without me. But Yi is really fed and he's a straight carry and they don't know what to do about it. Oh, and Lux just spamming ping on Morgana the whole time. I told him to go after Lux, I remember that. So he went after Lux instead of going after Morgana. Alright, let's... I think that was me, I was like... So their inhibitor's respawning soon. I still don't know if it was better to go for this tower, if it was better to go for the other inhibitor. Probably would have been better to go for the other inhibitor, but... I just remember here, you end up almost dying to get... You actually do die to get this tower, and look how low it is. We could have just come up here with another wave and gotten it instantly. And it... That wasn't... I remember you saying worth, and I don't remember if you actually... I don't know if you actually believed yourself, but it really wasn't, because it... You could have just let it go when they started to attack you, like when Misfortune used her ult, and we could have come back and gotten it like 2 seconds once we pushed this wave back up. But instead, three people are dead now, although Heim's worthless, so that's not huge. Lulu hasn't used her ult in a long time, just like you. It's your ult-her-ult combo that will wreck their team. But so now they're dead, and I can't do anything. I can't push a lane because they can kill me with their CC. Same with Yi, because we're both carries. So you've left two carries alive with no one to CC for them or to peel for them. And so you got the tower, and because we're mid, they don't push mid. Again, they're going, they keep going for other things. So they're going for drag here, where if they would have just grouped up mid, we wouldn't, Yi and I wouldn't have been able to defend this tower very well. Especially Yi, at least I've got some range. So yeah, Lee Sin didn't need to back, he could have shoved farther, but... So we're going and we're pushing again. We're pushing in, because I know I keep spamming pains and saying, no, we need inhibitors. And you see, I think you've seen several times now where as soon as we can, we push as hard as we can, and they kind of just goof around and go into the jungle. Lux blows her ult here. And the thing is both Yi and I have lifesteal, and so we can lifesteal all back rather quickly. You don't, but she... Is Lulu here? Lulu's here, just ult. Heimer's dinger is worthless. But if you can ult and get into the middle of their team and then have Lulu ult you, that would be phenomenal. Because the whole point is that we need... Ult! Ult! Unstoppable. We couldn't get a good engage right there. Let's look at that. Let's look at that really slowly. Hold on, a little bit slower than that. Alright, so we got Heimerdinger over here by himself, right? And then he just ults. Alright, so Lee comes in. Alright, right here. Right here. Hold on. So, I got hit by Lux Snare, which was my own fault. Oops, did I go back too far? Yeah, okay. So Heimerdinger's over here by himself, thinking that he can push the tower. And so, right here, Lee is in our team. But we don't really have anything we can do about it, because I was a little too far behind. And then so, I start to come in, and then I get hit by this, and I didn't have vision of the Lux. So I get hit by Lux's combo. And here we are, we've got another carry at the back, and he should be in the front. You're in the front where you should be as the tank. You should honestly just ult right here and hit these people with your ult, these four people. And so you're here, and then you just get scared. And so there goes my ult. I hit them with my ult. You can see a good chunk of damage there. Because Lulu hasn't yet ulted. So I die, like, instantly because I got hit by Lux combo, then Misfortune ult, because I was kind of out of position and I didn't see Lux. And then so Yi ult. He's going in because, he's a carry. He can do a shit ton of damage. At this point, you know, I don't know. If he manages to get Misfortune, then he might have actually been able to come out on top with this because he resets. But, you know, obviously it's a 4v5 and they've got more HP than you. Let's look at the team fight UI. Like, yeah, they've got double the health of you. So this blue thing is the health of our champions, the total health, and the purple health is the health of them. So they obviously have a lot more health. So that's probably why you didn't ult. I'm still kind of upset about this hex drinker, because you were supposed to be a tank and you got an AD item, but it's not important. So, let's see. He goes in. And Lulu, I think she ulted because she knew she was going to die, but she only hit one person with her pop-up because Yi couldn't get into their team fast enough. We all got caught right here outside the wall because we couldn't see them in here. So we got hit by all these skill shots that we couldn't dodge because we couldn't see. And see, look at his damage. It's just insane. He got ulted there by Lee Sin, so he couldn't do much. Really, I was out of position. Heimerdinger was out of position. We needed you to ult in, See, here you could have at least recalled in, like, Tri-Bush or something. I mean, he can't catch you because you're Shyvana, so you're really fast, but... We needed you to ult into a team fight, ult into their team, and have Lou ult you, and then just turn on your burnout and start auto-attacking people. Auto-attacking misfortune or Lux. And here again, they go for Baron, because I know it's respawning, and you can see here the timer is respawning in 15 seconds. But... it's obviously not respawned yet, and look at this. They're not pushing this down, even though... only you and Heim were alive. And they know Heim's top, because they saw him top. And they don't have the... Nasus knows you just recalled. So, they're taking the opportunity, they're pushing the side lanes instead of pushing the mid lane, where it's closest to the inhibitor. So this is really, really... a really bad play on their part, and it really helped us, the fact that they didn't get an inhibitor here. So, you know, Baron's up. They've got it pinked. No, we have it pinked. Yeah, we have it pinked and we can see their ward, but... so let's see. I go and take red. We're all kind of jungling, dicking around. And then we all decide as for... actually, here I'm coming to destroy the ward. Alright, so they ping this because they know we're here. That's what I said. I'm like, they know we're here because we just destroyed their ward. And I thought, you know, let's just kill them. And then I forgot that they're Lux and Misfortune. Look at this. So, that was honestly... We can watch that again if you want, but it's pretty obvious. We basically just get raped by all their AoE ults in a line. Lux ult hit five of us. So let's see. Alright, so we all get hit by Nasus Circle, which lowers our armor. It's doing a little bit of damage, not a significant amount. So, although, look, in total, our health is just a little bit below them. So we go on a little more. Here comes Lux. So that's, look at that snare. That was just the snare from Lux on Heimerdinger. You can see Misfortune hits us with her slow, which is doing some damage. Heimerdinger gets crit by Misfortune and just blows up instantly. So he's down. I'm trying to do damage, and there's not much I can do. Misfortune ult is coming out, hitting all of us, doing a lot of damage. And then, you see the health bars drop with each wave. And then, Lux ult comes out, which just absolutely wrecks us. And, you know, Misfortune ult is still going on. So, we just... absolutely good. This is so funny that you can just run into their team and then get a double kill even after losing that team fight so badly. Purple team double kill. So we can watch them again. So we're down for 40 seconds. They probably could have won the game here. They could have at least got an inhibitor. I know that for sure. And they don't. They go for Baron. So look at all this time they're wasting. Look at all that time. They're finally starting to push. They don't even push up to the tower. They go to our jungle. They're like, let's steal the buffs. So they're kind of dicking around and not pushing. So we decided to try and kill Misfortune. Although she runs away, so that's just a wasted effort. Let's see. So we know Heimerdinger gets caught. And then Yi jumps into their team because he knows he does a lot of damage. And he gets her because he does a lot of damage because he's a straight carry. So you ult, and Lulu doesn't ult you. Oh, looks like she doesn't end up needing to. Yeah, I get her. I run out of- alright, so the Misfortune ult's down. You guys are low, but I'm not. So, you know, rip Lulu, and I'm like, I can get him, he flashes, okay. I see Nasus coming, and I'm like, I'm leaving. And then, you're leaving in an obvious spot. You're lucky that he wanted to kill me more than he wanted to kill you. I think I end up leaving. Oh, no, I push bot a little bit. Do they come for me? Yeah, Miss. No, she just AFK'd. Yeah, they pinged me, and I left. I figured they would come for me. And they're like, no, let's just go for drag. So again, they're going for objectives. You can see that they're ahead of us on gold, but they're not really making use of it. And all our gold is centered on our carries. Lee and I. Sorry, Yee and I. And we're doing a lot of damage. So nothing. Go up and try and kill Nasus. And surprisingly, they actually get it. They managed to kill Nasus, which is huge. Because now they don't have anyone to tank in the next fight. The goal of the tank is just to absorb CC from their team. Absorb, get focused. They want to take damage, because if they're taking damage, that means the damage is not being applied to you. At least for auto attacks and single target abilities. You know, AoE abilities or whatever, but Lux just likes to miss skill shots. So we see them here around Baron. And they should have never been there. That is obvious. So we're chasing them a little bit. Your ult missed. And see, this is when I told you to ult. I know. And if you look. Alright, so he's got a turn in there. We know they're here. He walks right into that. If he would have walked to the right, it wouldn't have hit him. And Lee misses his skill shot. Alright. So any time that you could have hit him, right now ult. Now ult. But you kind of go around the long way, you see that? And so you finally ult right when she flashes, and then she throws her snare back and it hits us. And you see, now we can't follow up for you. So now you're in their team, which was fine. Might have been a bit better to ult back here, but we finally had you ult into a team fight like you needed to. And then we got hit by the snare, which was our fault. We didn't dodge it. And so now you're in their team. Unpause. And they could have just turned on you and killed you, but they knew we were coming. And he was fast because he used his thing. So yeah, keep fighting. Once he gets out of that, he's going to do a little... Oh, Lee gets a really, really good ult there. Because it hits all three of us. And if you see right here, Lulu just used her spooky ghosts, her twin shadows, which slowed him and revealed him. So yeah, you're dying, which is not surprising since you're in the middle of their team. And so I'm trying to kite him here. So the spooky ghost slowed him down right there, so he couldn't catch up to us. And then she used Shirelia's, you can see. So we're fast right now. So I can catch up to him, doing a lot of damage, hit them with my ult. She flashes. Lux whiffs her ult, absolutely whiffs it. And so that one Lux snare turned that entire fight into shit for us. Since we didn't dodge it. And yeah, so just run away. And it was because of Lulu that we got out, because she used her twin shadows to slow them and then used her Shirelia's to speed us up, and they pinged me out. Oh, I didn't know I had a ward there. But I saw her there, and I believe I like dodged this. Oh no! She's looking for us, and she didn't know Yi came too. So look at this. She ends up face checking this bush over here, and we just absolutely burst her. Look at that. That's so funny. And I'm like, hold on, I need red buff. Misses her ult again. This Lux is really making or breaking team fights. If she hits skill shots, we get destroyed. And if she misses them, we win the team fights. Because she's got a good amount of gold. Misfortune's fed too, but Misfortune's not that great at focusing or positioning or whatever. So she's not that huge. Lee Sin went damage. He's got some damage. So they're getting retreat things. Let's see, nothing interesting happens. Lux just blows her ult to try and clear away. I don't even know. Is it like all of lifesteal?
Blue team's turret has been destroyed.
Heimerdinger just died again. It's typical though. I finally got my GA, so I know that I won't get, even if I'm out of position, I won't get bursted. Lux keeps ulting to clear waves, so she doesn't have any team fight presence. When her ult's down, I don't think we end up, actually, we might end up getting her. Yeah, he does a lot of damage. So you're here, and I'm like, stay with me. Let's push this lane all the way up. Let's get an inhibitor. All right, so we go. We go. We go, we go. And they're not doing anything. And we go, and we go, and we go. All the way up here. They don't even ping us. It's like they don't even notice. So Nasus comes out of nowhere. And I get withered, so I can't do much. Morgana's behind us. And I see that, and I'm like, okay. I don't think I needed a flash, but I did that to make sure I missed her Q. I whiffed my ult, I completely missed, I'm like, lost. And this is my fault for attacking Lee Sin. I shouldn't have been attacking Lee Sin there. He had a random wins, which slowed my attack speed. She uses Shirelia's and Spooky Ghosts here to try and do the same thing. And they actually, we end up turning this fight around because of that. So this is what I was saying earlier, Morgana went AP. So she's 0 and 10, but she got a Death Cap and a Zhonya's. And if you look back at this Lulu, oh my god. So I had to leave because I was getting slowed by his Randuin's Omen. So every time I attacked him, it was slowing my movement speed and my attack speed. So she's Shirelia's and Spooky Ghosts right there. They keep them off just for a second. And then Misfortune stops. You know, for whatever reason, it's suddenly become a fight that Yi can win. And Yi sees that they start to go after Lulu, and Yi's a carry, you know, and he's really fed. So Yi's like, oh, I can go in on this. And I come around. So he starts going, and we start just focusing. They're just getting wrecked. And they're jumping on me, but I've got a GA anyway. So they're focusing me, but the thing is, there are two carries here. You see, he flashes after me. And because of this fight, because of the Spooky Ghost Shirelia is there, he managed to walk away just long enough so that way we could turn back on them and start focusing. Oh, my GA did pop. I didn't know my GA ever popped. So you see, that's the difference between a support who builds support and a support who builds damage. There was nothing that Morgana could do right here, and she missed her snare. If she would have used her Spooky Ghosts, if she has Spooky Ghosts, I wouldn't have been able to get away, and they would have been able to got to me because of the slow. But they didn't, and we win the game because of that fight right there, because we're able to turn on them, you kind of juke this bush here, and Yi comes back in, and Yi and I start critting them really, really hard. And it's GG. I don't know where you were at that last fight, actually. Were you dead? Yeah, I see that you were dead. So we killed him. I don't know where you are. Oh, this is the beginning of the fight. Alright, so you're here and you die. And you didn't ult again. I don't even have to say that. You know that you don't ult. Even when it's good to. Although Lulu used her ult there, so. If nothing else, jump in for the 400 magic damage. But, so yeah, Spooky Ghosts, you manage, Misfortune, I don't know what she does, if she DCs or something, she's not there. I believe she crits me as soon as she gets up. Yeah, she hit me with an auto attack Q. And so you're dead for the rest of the game. Oh, they just pinged me. That's what Lux was coming in for. They pinged me because they knew I had just revived from my DA. Because of that, we won the game. But see, that's another thing. Even if you don't ult, if they're focusing you and they're doing damage to you, that means they're not doing damage to you or me or you. So, GG easy. See, they had more kills than us and they had more gold than us, but they didn't ever make use of it. Look at the towers. And they had more dragons, I believe, but they never, ever even got an inhib. And they had all those opportunities to. They did Baron twice, they did dragon, they stole our jungle, but they never got an inhib. And another thing is that when you get an inhib, the creeps in the side lanes also have bonus HP. They don't have bonus damage. They obviously don't turn into super creeps, but they get more HP and they might get more damage. The siege creeps, anyway. I actually think all of the minions do. So even when you get an inhib mid, your side lanes will now all of a sudden push harder than their side lanes because your minions have just a little bit more HP. And that's why an inhibitor is so huge, because it makes an effect in all three lanes. That's something a lot of people don't know, that it gives HP to the side creeps too, to the other lanes. And so because of that, we were able to have minions in their base almost constantly, and they are never able to have minions push all the way up. That inhib was so big, and they never, ever, ever got it. They thought the other objectives were more important, and they didn't push the base when they could have. They were, I don't know, they just didn't, and it cost them the game. And that last team fight, we really turned it around, and a lot of it was Lulu's support items. It really helped us there. And then the entire game, this Aegis of the Legion really helped, because no one on their team got, oh, Nasus got it. Nasus did get it. That helped us a lot in that fight, too. So,